can't be her. But it was. There she was, across the parking deck. And I called out, Gina! Like the way you do when your level of surprise outweighs your polite standards, I yelled it. And my feet started to pick up speed. I was speed walking across the parking garage, smiling like you do when you see a friend, one that you haven't seen physically in over a decade. I'm waving and I'm smiling and I'm rapidly approaching this woman, my friend. I had shouted out to this woman. But wait a second. Oh my gosh. That's not Gina. My eyes are widening in new surprise, but my legs didn't get the message yet. And it was too late. I had shouted this woman's name, and my brain was in damage control as I considered my options, right? Number one, I could pretend it wasn't her I was shouting to. Number two, I could apologize and admit that I thought that she was someone else, right? But as I quickly measured these options, she spoke.
Oh my God, how are you?
And now she was moving toward me, this not Gina, smiling with her arms out as my brain struggled to figure out what was happening. Does she know me? Not Gina, approaching my body, frozen, my brain had given up, my face is covered in desperation and a plastic smile, and suddenly I'm hugging her. Not Gina, wondering if I might be having a little stroke. Was this Gina? Was I crazy? So I scanned her face as she spoke. She was asking about my family, my kids, my job. No specifics, I noticed. She hadn't used names, nor did she call me by my name, but then again, I wasn't really paying all that close attention. I was focused intently on her face, and I realized I had gone into autopilot, answering only in nods and short one and two word answers. Things like, they're good, it's great. My eyes were crazy, bugging out of my head, and my smile had stretched to the point of insanity. Who the heck is this person? What the heck is going on? What kind of a twisted game are you playing, not Gina? At this point, my brain was in total crisis mode. The crew that mans all of my conversational functions, they were gone. They retreated with everybody else to the memory bank looking for some clue, any clue that might give me the identity of this not Gina. All that was left was one very insecure teenage intern. And inside my brain, it sounded a little something like this. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, who is this? You have to know her. Wait. Now you're sweating, you have that little tiny bead of sweat on your lip, and she's going to think you're a crazy person. Maybe you are a crazy person. You just hugged a stranger, and now you're pretending that you know her. What if you do know her? What if not Gina is real Gina, and she had some sort of Kenny Rogers plastic surgery? Wait, what if you accidentally slipped it into an alternate universe? What if you're not you? Quick, look down at your hands. Yeah, those are your hands. Wait, stop looking at your hands! Wait, you just said something to her. What did you say? What did you ask her? Oh my gosh, stop talking. You are a crazy person. She just asked you a question. What did she ask? Wait, 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 what did you say? Why are you nodding? Oh my God, abort! Abort, abort, make up an excuse, any excuse, get out of there! And so I suddenly blurted out, I'm sorry, I have to go, bye, good to see you. And I ran back into my building and I stood next to the door with my back against the wall, crouched down like you do when you outrun the cops, I imagine. And I thought, what just happened? Not Gina seemed convinced that she knew me, but I didn't know her. And I was playing along. Why? Was it because I didn't want to embarrass her? Did I not want to embarrass myself? And then it occurred to me for the first time, what if not Gina was also pretending? What if the two of us were stuck awkwardly, swirling around in the unpleasantries of small talk and good social graces and fumbling away in this labyrinth of an exchange that had gotten away from us? I mean, the entire conversation felt like hours, but it was really only a few minutes, maybe 120 seconds of pretending that we knew each other. Well, not Gina said that she would message me and that we would have lunch, but she never did because she is a stranger. And I had just had an internal meltdown. As far as I can tell, not Gina was doing the same thing, pretending to be someone else, faking it, being the person that we thought the other person needed us to be. The two of us were lying to each other. We were lying to ourselves to protect this other stranger. We were faking it and faking it and faking it until the moment that we could escape, that we could get on with the rest of our day. And I thought, how often am I doing that? How many times in my day am I just going through the motions and I'm faking it, and faking it, until I can get to the next destination and fake it? So when I got back to my desk, I actually messaged Real Gina on Facebook. And we both had a good virtual chuckle, a lot of LOLs about the exchange. And then we started with the pleasantries. How's your job? It's good. How's your family? They're good. We should get together. Ironically, it was the same conversation that I had had with not Gina. And after we said our online goodbyes, I thought about my initial reaction when I saw who I thought was my old friend. I shouted her name in excitement. I started running, picking up my pace to start this would-be reunion. I thought about that for a while. Even when I did reach out to the real Gina, we ended up falling into those same fake situations, the forced small talk, the same niceties and pleasantries, and gone was the joy and the surprise I felt when I saw what turned out to be a stranger. I live in a world where every one of my old friends and my family members are available to me at the touch of a button, at the slide of a social media page. But I rarely reach out with that kind of enthusiasm that I felt when I ran into what turned out to be a stranger.